right, guys. Just got done warming up. We're about to get a leg workout in. This is actually gonna be the first workout of this whole series that we're gonna be doing. For the next 12 weeks, I'm gonna be busting my ass off because I need to look like this guy right here again. For the past 3 years, I've been, not gonna lie, been busting my ass, trying to make sure this business, Roman Empire Gym, becomes, you know, very successful. And I feel like so far we're doing a really good job, but this shit is tough. It sucks sometimes. I feel like I've let myself go very, very bad just because I've been so focused. And like I said, guys, this shit is very hard. It's not easy. Whoever's telling you that becoming an entrepreneur is easy and you can make millions of dollars off the comfort of your home or your laptop is full of shit. And they're probably making money off of you. So I'm here to tell you, I grew a business from $0 to now a multi-million dollar business. Shit's fucking hard. It's tough. And unfortunately, I had to sacrifice a little bit of my health. I had to sacrifice a little bit of my, a lot of my time. A lot of my time. And now it's just, I want to get back to, you know, being in shape. I want to get back to just a healthier version of me. And I feel like for me to keep doing what I'm currently doing and to, you know, to do this for a long period of time, you got to take care of your health. And I feel like right now it's time. So that's where we're going to be focusing for the next couple of weeks. I think that 12 weeks is a good start. Obviously, I want to keep doing this for after 12 weeks. I want to maintain this, but I need to get back in shape, guys. It's been a rough journey, but we can always get back to it. So now it's time to do it. We're gonna hit some legs. After that, we're gonna be doing some cardio. And after that, I'm gonna be kind of like going over the macros and everything, what the game plan is, how are we gonna be starting this, and what the goal is, right? Because yeah, we wanna look good. We wanna get back to being in shape, but what is a long-term goal? I feel like that's only just to get my feet wet, just to get myself started in that direction again. And after that, how are we gonna maintain that? And what are we gonna do after that? Very important. But yeah, guys, so like I said, welcome. This is the first video of the series. Let's get to work. All right, guys, I'm gonna sit down for a second. Just got done with my first workout cardio session. We did 30 minutes on the Stairmaster today. That was horrible. It was really, really bad. So I haven't done cardio in a very, very long time. Like I would walk, you know, on the treadmill or maybe do a little bit of bike and stuff like that. But I haven't done stairs in a very, very long time. So that was brutal. Workout was good. I feel like I've been eating a lot, like today. I'll go over my macros here in a little bit, but it's been rough. It's been a rough couple of years, guys. And you know, it finally hit me, like last week. I was woke up in the morning, hadn't weighed myself in a while, and I didn't like the number, to be honest. And I feel like maybe a lot of you guys can relate. Step on the scale, it's been a while. It's a little higher than you were expecting, and I did some check-ins this morning, and honestly, I wasn't very proud of them. I'll go ahead and post them right here so you guys can see. So this was taken this morning, and like I said, I just wasn't very happy with it. I think I really just let myself go, and you don't really realize it until you're actually like, until you actually like look. You know, I've recorded myself this morning, and I hadn't done that in years, and it just hit me, like, I can't keep doing this. I can't keep eating the same way, you know, I've been eating. I've been skipping the gym, and I own a gym, so that's kind of sad, right? I feel like I can say that I've just been so focused on the business side, but
I think that's just making up excuses. I really do think I can do both. I mean, I feel like just taking an hour and a half out of my day and just spend that on myself, I mean, it's very doable, right? So moving forward, that's what we're gonna be doing. This morning, I weighed myself as well. I'll go ahead and post the footage right here too, so you guys can see my current weight. That was this morning, fasted, no food. I woke up at 7 a.m. and that is pretty much the starting point, guys. It's not, like I said, it's not what I was expecting, but we're doing something about it, right? We're not just going through the motions and just complaining, and we're getting to work, guys. That's the reason why we're doing all this. And I think I can do it in 8 weeks. I really do. I don't like today I started with cardio, you know, I started with legs. I don't want to ease into it. I just want to go ahead and get it going, you know? So I know I can do the cardio. I know I can do the workouts. That's not a problem. The problem is, you know, the dieting and eating certain amount of calories and macros and all that stuff. And let's go ahead and go over the macros. Actually, I have it on my tablet. I've been trying to be as organized as possible recently, because let me tell you what, your boy is not very organized. So that's gonna be one of the things that I'm gonna focus on this year. Gotta be very organized, okay? I feel like it's gonna translate into business and all that stuff, but let's go ahead and go over macros for the rest of the week. Now, when it comes to macros, really, I want to start out as high as possible, right? Like, I don't know how my body's going to respond to anything right now, so there's no need for me to, like, assume what my caloric deficit is going to be and, you know, what my calories are going to be at right now. So I'd much rather just go a little higher and then see, you know, the first week, second week, see how it goes, and then make adjustments according to that. And sometimes, you know, the answer is not decreasing food or, you know, carbs or whatever it is. Sometimes just moving a little more, like just maybe walking on the treadmill for an hour a day on top of your Stairmaster or your sprints, you know, whatever it is that you're doing. I feel like sometimes just moving just helps out a lot. Maybe having a little more intense workouts. Decreasing food is not always an answer. There's definitely a balance of decreasing food, increasing cardio. You don't want cardio to be the main source of, like, why you're losing weight. You want it to be a combination of everything. I feel like cardio is just a tool that you use. It shouldn't be the main reason why you're losing weight. But moving on to the macros of this week. So we're gonna be starting out at 200 grams of protein, 280 grams of carbs, and then we're gonna be doing 50 grams of fats. Overall, we're looking at around 2,300 calories, which is, I think it's a little low. Just because I'm almost done, you know, with all my food today, and I'm still a little hungry. But, you know, we're gonna make adjustments as we go. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I want to make this as enjoyable as possible to watch. Also, you know, the main reason why I'm recording this is because, yeah, I want to share my progress. And honestly, I feel a little weird putting myself out there like that. But I feel like I'm gonna look back at this and I'm gonna be like, damn, I've come a long way. Just because I know that I can do it. I've done it plenty of times. There's been, when I was younger, in my early 20s, I mean, I've always been in shape. I've always had abs since I was a kid. And recently, 3 years ago, when I was in the middle of the expansion of Roman Empire Gym, I was so busy. I didn't have time to work out. My sleep schedule was everywhere. I was eating garbage because I didn't have time to actually meal prep and all that stuff. Like, this is very stressful. Like I said earlier, guys, if you want to start your own business, if you were, like, serious about it, you're gonna have to sacrifice a few things here and there, whether it be a little bit of health, whether it be time with your loved ones, time with your significant other. Like, it's just one of those things that's gonna happen, and sometimes it's a combination of all of them, right? And I feel like that's what happened to me. And I think that a lot of entrepreneurs can relate to this, of course, especially if you're just getting started, especially if you have no funding from anyone, if you don't have any investors, if it's just you. Like, it's really stressful, guys. And recently, this past year, I've actually been able to bring people onto the team. But before that, it was literally just me. Like, I had nobody. It was just me, and it was horrible. Like, this is very hard to do what I've done. It's been, I'm not gonna say like it's the hardest freaking thing in the world, but it was pretty freaking hard, man. And now I want to take advantage of the fact that we have so many people on the team, and I want to get back to myself. And I feel like if I can just make 2 hours out of my day and then just like focus on some me time, I think that's where, you know, that's where this is gonna come in handy, and just focus on myself, guys. I wanna get back in shape. But yeah, that's gonna be it for tonight. I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna shower, eat, and I'll see you guys in the morning.
What is going on, guys? Today is Tuesday. It is currently 9:30 in the morning. We're about to make breakfast. We got a few meetings after this. I gotta be at the gym at 10, and then I have a meeting at 11, and then we have a meeting at 2. So the meeting at 2 I'm excited about, because our turf is finally getting installed, which I've been waiting for quite a bit now. I think it's been 9 weeks since we've ordered it, so it's finally getting done, so I'm excited for that. Let me show you guys what we're gonna be making for breakfast this morning. So when it comes to dieting, I try to keep things as basic as possible and as simple as possible. And I don't like doing the whole, like, just doing the whole if it's your macros kind of thing throughout the day. Like I like knowing exactly what I'm eating. I like prepping like the food prior to, you know, I like to prep for a couple of days. I don't wanna just be on that day trying to figure out, you know, what I'm gonna be doing to, if, you know, fill in those macros and stuff like that. So for breakfast, we're gonna be doing oats, and then we're doing 1 scoop of protein as well. For the oats, we're gonna be doing 80 grams, and I like to throw in a little bit of almond butter. So we're gonna be doing 16 grams of almond butter, and we're gonna be doing 80 grams of blueberries. I don't really weigh out the blueberries. Obviously, we do have to weigh out the oats just because they're very caloric dense. But this is pretty much breakfast. We're gonna make it. We're gonna put everything together. And also, let me show you guys some of the supplements we're gonna be taking. So in the morning, what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be using two different brands. We're gonna be using Axis Sled, and we're gonna be using Revive. So with the Revive stuff, I like them. They're kind of like on the pricier side, but this stuff is really good. It's high quality stuff. We're gonna be doing multivitamins from Axis Sled, elbow grease, because you know your boy's getting old, so I gotta take care of these joints. And then we're gonna be doing Axis Sled greens as well. We're gonna be doing this. I'm missing the fish oils. We're gonna be using Axis Sled's fish oils as well. And I also bought this CLA L-carnitine kind of like mix, and I wanted to try it. So I don't think it's gonna help me like burn fat or anything like that. I just think it's gonna help with recovery, and I think it's gonna help me kind of like digest food maybe a little bit better. I don't think there's anything out there that's gonna make you lose fat unless it's like a fat burner or steroids, which we're gonna stay away from forever. We're not gonna mess with that. But yeah, I've been taking this. I actually started taking it yesterday, and I like it. It was good. You know, it's good. The only thing that I am missing is some creatine. So I'll probably stop by the store and get some of that today. But yeah, this is gonna be breakfast. We're gonna make it, and then we're gonna head to the gym, okay? Get a busy dad. Sometimes I wake up in the morning and I don't wanna get up. I just wanna like lay in, because I go to sleep pretty late. Like I wake up, well, I'm gonna be prioritizing sleep, right? So if I go to sleep, I have to get at least 7 hours of sleep every night. So if I go to sleep at 1, you know, I gotta sleep 7 hours after that. If I go to sleep at 2 or 3, I gotta, you know, sleep for 7 hours after that. So that's kind of like, that's my system that I'm doing. But I think that's gonna have to change a little bit, just because I would like to be at the gym by 10. And I know some of you guys might think that's a little late, but I do go to sleep very, very late. It's because I'm just a night person and I like working at night. You know, nobody's bothering me and there's nobody here. It's just me and I can actually work. A lot of back in work. We're getting everything ready for tax season. every year, and we're gathering a bunch of documents and paperwork and stuff like that, which I need to get more organized, guys. Yeah, we're gonna be working on that this year. But yeah, we're gonna make this. I'm gonna start talking, and I'll see you guys in a little bit.
So turf meeting went pretty good. So the goal is to get it installed sometime this week. We're thinking that maybe Thursday or Friday. So we're just kind of like going over, you know, where it's gonna go, you know, how we're gonna go about the installation process and all that stuff. But it seems pretty straightforward. I think the biggest thing is just making room for it, you know, for all the tools and all that stuff, for the forklift and everything to go in there and kind of like take everything apart, because we do have to get rid of the old one, throw that one away, and then bring the new one in. And the good thing is that the old one is not glued down, so we don't have to do, you know, like anything, we don't have to do any, like, fuck. We don't have to, no, just keep rolling, fuck it. Yeah, we don't have to close down the gym or anything, fuck. We don't have to close down the gym or anything, so it's gonna be a very easy process. So yeah, that went good. Let me show you guys something that we just did to my truck. The TRX, baby. Rubbing and purging. Yeah. She's done. Hell yeah, man.
Brand new again. Touch it for a couple hours, right?
Yeah.
Whenever you get home, just put it in the garage. Drive it.
It doesn't fit in the garage, but it can stay outside, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Yes. So if you can, just for the time being that you're over here,
yeah,
just work it under the sun.
Okay.
That way it bakes into the ceramic coating.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Also, whenever you get a chance, this is the sticker for your warranty.
Okay.
Okay. So it's supposed to be in the ceramic is supposed to be in the vehicle for like about 5 years.
Okay.
If you have any issues with it, you just scan that, and also you can add it to your Carfax.
Okay. That's awesome, man. Thank you, bro. I appreciate that. So we did look at this. It's brand new. Hold on. Tell them what we did.
Oh, we did a complete interior cleaning, one-step paint correction, and we added a five-year System X ceramic coating to the paint. We polished the rims. We cleaned his tires. We conditioned all the rubber and plastic bumpers. So, CKS detailing, baby.
Hell yeah. So, if you guys need any detailing, hit this man up. Wait, let me get a picture of the back.
Oh, the back?
Yeah. That's it. He does the Lambo as well, and you know, he's been taking care of this one. Look at this, it looks beautiful. Well, yeah, thank you, man, I appreciate it, bro. Look at that, man, it looks brand new. It looks better than new, actually, man. It looks clean, bro. Honestly, sometimes whenever I like, now that I'm looking at my truck all nice and clean, I do miss the Lambo. Like, it was like shiny black like this when I first got it. No, but we wrapped it recently, but I wouldn't mind if we went back to this, like a nice shiny, you know, black. That looks nice. All right, guys, almost done with the warm up. 20 minutes here, about to hit some chest and tries. Then I got 30 more minutes on the treadmill. Like I said, we're just gonna keep the body moving. Today we're gonna go pretty heavy on chest, just because I'm feeling good, have a lot of energy. So we're gonna go heavy. I'm working out with Bro John today. He's gonna push me to the workout, or I'm gonna push him. Who knows? We're gonna push each other. Yeah. Get to work. Everything you wanted, fading in the moment. Everything sacrificed. The peace that you once knew, waking up within you. The battle of your life. Oh, that was heavy. First time doing 90s in about 2 years. Some good shit. Second exercise in, I'm already getting fatigued. I think the first exercise killed me. I usually warm up with 3 plates on this press. One of my favorite press bars for strength. It's gonna be a rough workout, I can already feel it. Thank you, Bro John.
You're welcome. I'm feeling it too.
Good. chicken workout has been done. Now we just gotta do some cardio. We're just walking on the treadmill for 30 minutes. And that is it for today's video, guys. Follow my journey. It's gonna be fun. I'm excited. I can't wait for this next 12 weeks. The end result is gonna be amazing, I already know. Let's make it happen. See you guys in the next one.